This old highway seems so lonesome when you're going where you've been. And a lonesome song can make you cry time and time again. If I had listened to a friend of mine 10 years ago today, I'd have a better job than what I got today. But the billboards on the highways and the brake lights on the cars make me jump out on the highway with my bag and my guitar. If she comes or if she goes, it doesn't matter anymore, 'cause I'm riding my thumb to Mexico. Riding my thumb to Mexico. It don't matter when or how I go. I'll ride this thumb till I see her again. So I'm riding my thumb to Mexico. Well, the reason why she left me's not the reason that I'm here. I'm a traveling kind of man, just need a change of atmosphere. If there's any place I haven't been at all, that's where I'll go. So I'm riding my thumb to Mexico. Riding my thumb to Mexico. It don't matter when or how I go. I'll ride this thumb till I see her again. So I'm riding my thumb to Mexico.
Many years ago, and all I ever wanted was to ride in the rodeo. If you'd give me the courage to make that long, hard ride, I'd want to be a cowboy till I die. Well, I bumped heads with every wild boy, Fort Worth to Cheyenne. Every time I hit the dirt, well, I got back on again. But now I'm down here hoping that I don't let you down. I think it's time we turn my life around. Lord, I've traveled many lonely miles. Take my saddle, let me rest a while. My heart is weary and my bones are sore, and I don't want to be a cowboy anymore. There's a girl in San Antonio, the one I left behind. Riding for the money was the first thing on my mind. I'm hoping she'll forgive me for making that mistake, 'cause all I want now is the love she makes. Lord, I've traveled many lonely miles. Take my saddle, let me rest a while. My heart is weary and my bones are sore, and I don't want to be a cowboy anymore. My heart is weary and my bones are sore. Hang my trophies in the Hall of Fame. Tell all the ladies to remember my name. I don't wanna be a cowboy anymore.
The sun was hard and I was beaten. My mare was tired and the fence line I was riding stretched forever. My mind drifted off and back to Carmella and her heart of black and the things that she'd said to me yesterday. So when the boss sent me out checking fences, I was glad because I knew that it meant that I could spend some time out all alone. I wiped the sweat that stung my eyes, looked up and I realized that I was coming up on the south windmill. The concrete tank stood there beside the water trough that it supplied. When the trough was full, the mill could keep on pumping and pumping and pumping and pumping. So we drove drank deep from the shallow trough and wet my hair gave me the thought that a swim in that big tank might cool me down. So I shut my duds and hung them on the fence, climbed the wires and reached the rim, pulled myself on up and jumped right in. The water was cool down underneath, but deeper than I thought it'd be. There was no ladder and the walls were slick with moss. Sure enough, I got cooled down when I found I had no way out, and the thought of a rat in the feed then chilled my blood. Well, at first I laughed at the fix I was in, then my troubles all sank in. Without some help, I was there to stay. I screamed and clawed to no avail, till dignity and voice had failed. I wore my fingers down on those damned walls, and I marked the time with the windmill shade, passing across my mossy grave, and the cows coming to water twice a day. Strike or rattlesnake or barroom fight would do me in, not some Mexican rose. The fact is I was hot and dumb, struck stupid by the sun and love. So on the one hand, I guess she played her part. Through all that time, I cussed her lots, but I cussed myself the most because I had not looked before I'd left. Now overhead an eagle soars, and I smell rain coming from the north. I wonder if she'll even shed one tear.